5,500 kilometres into Kenya, into the Great Rift Valley. I think all three of us have had the privilege of going up there. The conditions clearly very, very different there. Let's just let's park that thought for the moment. Another transition about to come up. We're about to hand over to the next team. And this is team five. This is the next changeover. They'll take them through from 18 to 23 kilometres. And the captain, Shalane, of this team, team five, a man you know very well indeed.
Yes, teammate of mine of the Bowerman Track Club, Matt Centrowitz. Centrowitz is one of the most decorated middle distance runners of our generation, and he's current Olympic 1500 meter champion. He's 29 years old, soon to be 30, and a team captain. He's a great communicator. He loves to talk, for sure. If anyone knows Matt, he's a talker. And there he is, slipping in, blocking Elliot. Matt is a great athlete to run behind. He is so smooth. And as an athlete, you always like to run really nice behind the clean runners that have as little back kick as possible.
They have just run in front of our commentary position, and I kid you not, blink and you miss them. It was an absolute blur, Ed.
They are something else to watch. I love watching Matt Centrowitz run.
Right?
Yeah.
It's beautiful.
It's
so effortless. Yep, he just came off of the World Championships. He ran 3:32 in the final. Incredible. We also have Shadrach Kipchirchir from the USA. He was also in Doha. Hilary Boer from the USA. Noha Kipkemboi of Kenya. Chela Ragasa.
Yeah, one of two Ethiopians in the team.
And Matt Centrowitz of USA, the captain, right in front of Eliud. Solomon Barega of Ethiopia.
Yeah, the 19-year-old silver medalist in the 5,000 meters in Doha.
And our last one, Moses Koek.
So it's all change. Ed, I'm just wondering, was that perhaps not the smoothest of the transitions we've seen today?
Yeah, I think that was, you know, you saw the way that Matt Centrowitz just had in his mind he was going to shield Elliot right from the very first moment, so he even shifted across with him. That was very cool. They seem to be executing these really well. You know, what the thing that to look for is, you know, I think it's Eric Kiptonou who's got to do three of these. You know, he's been asked to basically do a rep session where he does 3 times 5K at 14:30, you know, with a long gap in between. Let's see how good their changes are the third time he has to do it, you know, because there's going to be fatigue.
The athletes will be, you know, the paces are going to be getting
fatigued.
Yeah.
So, you know, the first ones you'd hope would be really good, everyone be on their toes. The real skill is going to be to do it when you're tired.
Well, the current captain of this latest team, Matt Centrowitz, has just started his journey. The previous captain, Julian Vanders from Switzerland, who spends a lot of his time up with Elliot in Kenya, he's with Crystal now.
Julian, as captain, tell us about that role and how crucial it is for today.
Yeah, my role as a captain is very important because actually Elliot is supposed just to follow me. So he's not supposed to think about anything, just follow me. And I also have to lead the guys in front of me. So if they are not on the line, I have to tell them, stay on the line, go a bit more in front. And also it's important in the roundabout because this is a little bit tricky. There is no lane anymore with the laser. So I have to keep the right lane, so in the inside as much as possible so that we don't lose time on the roundabout, yeah.
So special to be in this event, but running almost to make Elliot's dreams come true.
Yeah, it's a big honor. I think all of the pacemakers are so happy to be here. It's a privilege, and you know, for us, we are just a small part. I mean, running 5K is nothing compared to 42 kilometer, and I can say it's a big, big inspiration. And I think he's really showing that there's no limit in his mind. Yeah.
And Julian, you have such a connection to Kenya. I love your bracelet. It says "Run" in Swahili. Tell us about Kenya, the experience of training with Elliot.
Yeah. So for me, I live in Kenya for now 4 years. I don't train with Elliot, but not far in Iten. And I have an amazing group to train with. We push each other every day, and I just like the mentality of the Kenyans. It's just so amazing, so inspiring, and it has helped me to improve so much. And I think I just find the right environment for me. I just feel like I'm Kenyan now.
A native Kenyan now. originally from Switzerland. So 19 kilometres completed. The next milestone, of course, will be the 20K mark. 56.52 would put him bang on course. So we've got a couple of minutes, Ed. Let's just go back to the Great Rift Valley and what it's like up in El Doret and Kaptabat. There's the latest splits coming through, 2.50s, and they've just slightly increased there, 2.48 Chalane for that latest kilometre.
I mean, they're right on target. We'll get our... Yeah, it says on target. I think it says under 11 seconds. But we'll get the real feedback when we hit 20K. Like you said, we want to be 56.49.
Yeah, 56.52 or something thereabouts for 20K. And 59.57 through halfway. So the next milestone will be halfway. Kaptagat, 2,400 metres at altitude. Here we are in Vienna at 165 metres above sea level. The conditions up there, Ed, very, very different. Just take us there.
Yeah, the only similarity really is that Elliot's training camp is in a forest. So he has this very simple training camp. They go for long runs through the forest and all around dirt roads. They come back, wash from water from a well. You know, it really is quite rudimentary. The training is quite often quite early in the morning, especially the long run. They would go out, you know, at sort of 5:45, 6 o'clock.
And, so before sunrise.
Yeah, and you know, the very fun thing is to follow them along in the, you know, in the Matatu bus and then watch as the sun comes up, and you've got this huge group of runners, many of them world class, you know, running their 40k long run. That's, you know, that's fabulous to watch.
And Shalane, in terms of diet, when they're in the training camp, again, it's pretty basic stuff, but it's all high nutrition.
Yeah, it's all high quality ingredients because it's locally sourced from the land right there. They have a diet of milk from local cows. They have beet juice, rice, ugali, which is like a maize flour, which is a Kenyan staple, and occasional meat. But it's just really simple foods. There's not a lot of processed.